metric, the unit name is pictorial projection. Pictorial projection. Pictorial projection is nothing but it's a three-dimensional drawing. Right? 3D, just a drawing, 3D view. The way we are going for this three-dimensional views in a technical drawing, anybody? Why we need a three-dimensional view in a technical engineering drawing? What is its need? Tell me. What is its need for pictorial views? If I have a three-dimensional view of a component, it is more easier for me to visualize. Okay, for visualizing, clear visualization purpose, we are going for a three-dimensional view. Right. So any technical drawing nowadays you can see in a corner, right corner, there will be a three-dimensional view. And that is a pictorial drawing will be there. It can be an isometric view or perspective view. Right. Is it clear? A three-dimensional view, a pictorial view will be given in a technical drawing. Its main purpose to visualize the component. Okay. More clearly. Because the two-dimensional drawing, orthographic projectional views, if it is given, that alone it is given, then there will, you have to link the views. Okay, front view, top view, side view, you have to link it and you have to interpret the three-dimensional view. Right. So if I have given a three-dimensional view itself, so it's more easier for you to visualize the component. Right. So apart from that, the details will be given in the 2D orthographic views. Right. So that is the purpose we are going for a pictorial drawing projection. So in pictorial projection, we have two broader projection. One is isometric projection, isometric projection. Another one is perspective projection. These two will be the two halves of your fifth unit. Right. Isometric projection and perspective projection. Okay, in the fifth unit, the final question will be one half will be isometric, in another half will be in perspective projection. Right. Clear. So here in isometric projection, we begin a 3D view. It's a standard 3D view. Right. It will have only one view. So it is a standard three-dimensional view. Standard 3D view. Why I'm saying standard? It is drawn to a fixed axis, that is x, y, and z axis. Right. Fixed axis. That is standard three-dimensional view. That is an isometric view. So perspective projection will be drawing. It is more realistic three-dimensional view. More realistic in the sense. So even I can say it is a more realistic view in the sense. It is a photographic image of the component. If I have a component there, if I take a photograph from here, it looks different. Okay, the same component, if I take a photograph from another location, that appearance will differ. Okay, but it will be a realistic one. Okay, depends upon where you are looking at the object, it will view. It will be different. So that is a more realistic one. I can say it is a photographic view. Graphic. So we will come to this later. Similarly, the isometric projection, normally we will be using this isometric projection or isometric views for smaller components. Right. That is, a smaller component is a small machine components. Small machine components will be represented in isometric views. Okay. The perspective projection, it is used for representing bigger size, larger size objects. Okay, larger space objects is a larger or bigger objects. Larger objects will be represented in perspective projection. The larger objects in the sense what? Perspective projection. building drawings, okay, any architectural drawing, building drawings, it will be represented in perspective projection, perspective view, right? Right, so for larger objects, so we will be representing mostly using perspective projection. Small emission components will be represented in isometric projection, right? So that is the difference. Then, so this part perspective projection I will come to later. So we will go on to isometric projection, the first term. Okay, what is isometric projection? What is isometric view? Right, so we take isometric projection. Okay, in the view from, we given a 2D data, or half to draw 3 dimensional view, right? Isometric projection. So in isometric projection, we have, two things. Now, what is isometric projection? If you are asked to draw isometric projection, what is that? If you are asked to draw isometric view, what is that? Okay. Isometric projection. The component will be represented in either isometric projection. To be shown in isometric view. What is the difference between this? Right, isometric projection in the sense you have to use an iso scale. So all the dimensions will be converted to an isometric scale and it will be represented in an isometric view. Right, so we will be using iso scale for this. So all the dimensions will be converted to iso scale, that is 0.82. So if I have 1 mm, it should be converted as 0.2 mm and it should be measured and it should be drawn in 3-dimensional view. Right. So we will be using isometric scale to represent an isometric projection of any component. Right? So in isometric view, the true length, directly is used. True length, whatever the dimension is given, the same dimension will be measured. So here, the dimensions are converted to isometric scale and it will be drawn in a 3-dimensional view. Right. True length, the exact length. So you can see, so in isometric projection, the 3D view will be a smaller one or bigger one compared to isometric view. Smaller one is 0.82, that is 1. Right. So the view drawn in isometric projection, it will be a smaller one. So it will be all the dimensions are converted in iso scale and it is drawn, shown in 3D view. Here, it is on the same size, so definitely the isometric view will be in bigger size. So in your exercises, in your class, you are asked to draw isometric view mostly, right? Because you need to convert 0.8, but to remember isometric projection, it should be converted to used with isometric scale, right? So in your problems, you will be using showing isometric views, the same dimensions you can use it, okay, you need not convert it. Is it clear? So we'll consider a cube, yeah. You know the isometric projection, or consider the cube. Consider a cube. So how the isometric, standard isometric view is drawn? So from a cube, I can explain it clearly. So suppose I have a cube like this, right, cube in this orientation, can you see all the 3 dimensions in this, the cube, only one dimension I can see, that is the front face I can see, right, so clear, the front face only is seen in this orientation. Suppose I want to show another dimension of this cube, another dimension, just if I rotate it like this, I can see the another dimension of the cube. So I can see this face, I can see this face. So still the third dimension is missing. Because the 3 dimension, what I have to do, the third dimension is the one to show it. This whole face I have to tilt it. So I can tilt it like this. Now I can see this face, and this face. So this is the orientation. It's used for represent the isometric view. So exactly if you want, how it will be, these 3 faces, how it is in inclined to the wall. Wall is nothing but my what? Vertical plane. So that vertical plane, how these faces tilt them, they are equally tilted to the vertical plane. They are equally tilted to the vertical plane, such that if it is equally tilted, what will happen to this corner and the opposite corner? It will be perpendicular. Right. So then what will happen to this diagonal and the diagonal opposite? It is parallel. Okay. It's again, it's perpendicular to HP. So in this orientation, it will be tilted. So while if it is tilted like this, I can see all the three faces, three dimensions, and that three faces is equally inclined to the vertical plane. So similarly, the diagonal opposite, joining the diagonal opposite, is perpendicular to the VT. So now in this orientation, if I draw it, the cube will be like this. Exactly.
Actually, in the square face, the cube in the square face,
because of tilting, it has turned into a rhombus, that face, right? So that's where, so just see, I am representing this as A, O, B, this C. Consider this triangle AOB and AOC, right? Both these triangles, okay, both these triangles are symmetric. Okay, it is symmetric for AOB and AOC. Consider AOB, AOB. You see here, this AC is a true length. The same AC is, during, after tilting, it is turned into AB. Okay, that is my, going to be my isometric length. But it is one unit. AC, the AD will be the corresponding isometric length of one unit, right? So if you are able to find out AB, that is going to be your isometric scale. So AOB, triangle AOB, from triangle AOB, I am trying to find out AO by AB by AO, AB by AO. So AB, it is one. What is AO? It will be, what will be this angle? Tell me. In between AB and AO, it will be 30 degrees. Because this, if I draw an example in here, this overall is 120, this will be 30. Then this will be 30. What will be this if after drawing a square? That is AC to AB, it is 45. So equally inclined, okay, sir. It is 45, this is 30, that you know. Okay, in this 30. So if this angle is 30, so if this is a triangle, AOB I am considering. So AO will be what? Cos of 30, cos 30. So it will be cos 30 degree. So cos 30 is nothing but my root 3 by 2. It will be 2 by root 3. So you consider a triangle AOC. AOC, again I am taking AC to AO, AC by AO, it is 1 by, what is AO here? Considering this triangle cos 45, so cos 45 is 1 by 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, it is root 2. Now since these two triangles are symmetric, I can use it, I can divide this AD by AO by AC by AO, 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 it cancels, so it will be 2 by root 3 by root 2 by root 3. So root 2 will be root 2. So it will be root 2 by root 3. That will be root 2 by root 3. Here it is divided by 1. So it will be root 2 by root 3. So now you tell me what is AB, what is AC. AB is my isometric length, iso length of unit. AC will be my true length. That is one unit, true length. AC is my true length, AB is my iso length. So how I can write it? This AB is my iso length, iso length. Iso length by true length is equal to AB by this. So iso length by true length. So what is going to be my isometric length now? So what is root 2 by root 3 now? What is the value it is? So tell me this value, root 2 by root 3, it is going to be 0.82. Right? It is going to be 0.82 approximately. So you will be having other digits. Right? So it is approximately 0.82. So now my isometric length will be is equal to this isometric length, it is 0.82 into true length, it is 0.82 into true length. So if you are drawing an isometric projection, you have to convert all your true lengths into 0.82. The 0.82 is nothing but my isometric scale value, right? So to represent an isometric, you will be using a cube tilting equally all its faces to EP, right? That is the one to represent an isometric cube, right? Have any clarification? I take isometric scale. So isometric scale, it will be, so normally it is represented with 30 degree and 45 degree. The scale will be shown here from a horizontal, a 30 degree line and a 45 degree line. A 30 degree line will represent what? Right? Isometric length, iso length. 45 degree line, inclined line will represent my true length. So this is the scale. Okay. So normally any true length we have, so you say that that's what I have, the true length will be measured in the isometric length. That is the true length of the duster. Okay. So that true length I can mark. Right. So to corresponding iso length, if I want to find it out, what I have to do it? Just I have to project that point. Just I have to project that point vertically perpendicular to the iso length. That length, this length, is going to be my iso length of the dust of my duster. So if I want to represent the isometric view of my duster, so this length, it is measured in true length and it is projected to the iso scale. Okay, so that length should be used to represent the isometric view of the duster. Okay, so corresponds similarly all the dimensions. So what I can say, so isometric scale is nothing but it is 0.82 into, it's approximate 0.82 into true length. Clear. So if, suppose you have 100 mm, I can mark it on 45 degree true length scale. It will project it to, that is 82. Exactly it will have 82, right? Not exactly, approximately 82. So exactly in iso scale only will have, right? Then isometric axis. So normally the isometric axis, I have three isometric axes. How it is? Three isometric axes. It is like this. Okay, the three edges of the cube. So the isometric axis will be like this. Three axes. So they are how much angle it is about? X, Y and Z. So they are, so the angle between any two isometric axes will be 120 degrees. So if you are asked in question, angle between the isometric axis will be 120 degrees, not it is 30 degrees. So to construct, will be using 30 degrees. So how to construct the isometric will be using 30 degrees. What is that? It's nothing but, suppose I draw a horizontal line here in this one, what will be this angle? 30 degrees. Okay, 30 degrees. Normally to construct the isometric view, will be going for the horizontal line, reference line, then we will be drawing 30 degree lines like this. Okay, these 30 degree lines are nothing but what? Mine? These two 30 degree lines are nothing but my two axes, this is x and y axis, two axes, right? Two isometric lines are nothing but my two axes, x and y axis. The other axis will be how I have to represent it. By constructing, I need not project it downwards, I can use a vertically upward axis also, I can direct, okay? Using these two axes, I can construct the base. The other axis will be used for my other axes, are either downwards or upward, I can use it for my, represent my height. Right. So, normally the isometric axes are not inclined to 30 degree, it is inclined to 120 degree. Normally, for drawing isometric, will be using like this, 30 degree from a horizontal will be using two axes, another axis will be used for height. Right. So, but the isometric axes are inclined to 120 degrees, right? Now, the isometric line if a line, any line is drawn parallel to the isometric axis. So any line, if we draw it parallel to isometric axis, that is nothing but isometric lines. Okay. So any line drawn parallel to isometric axis, right, all the three axes, so then it will be, so any one of, if any line drawn parallel to any one of the isometric axes, then it is an isometric line. So in cube, all the edges are parallel. So whatever cube we have considered, that cube, all the edges are parallel to any one of the isometric axes. They are isometric lines. So then, non-isometric lines, non-isometric line. So the non-isometric line is nothing but, so any line in an isometric view drawn is not parallel to the isometric axis, any of the isometric axis, then that is a non-isometric line. Okay. So that the diagonality what we have considered, okay, that is not parallel. So that one is not parallel. Okay. So that line is a non-isometric line. So then methods. Methods draw a box method. The other one, the box method is mostly used for to draw the isometric views of the prism, cylinders, okay, prisms, cylinders. Okay. Cylinders, in the sense, in cylinder we have a circle. For that circular one, for the circle, to draw the isometric view for the circle, we will be using a method called four-centered method. So we can have another one, four-centered method. Four-centered method. Right. Four-centered method is used to draw the isometric view of a circle alone. Then we have offset method. Then we have offset method. It is used to draw the isometric views of the pyramids. Pyramids and cone. Right. So the box method, we will be drawing a box for a base. We will be drawing a base, then it is in the other dimension, the height is extended. Here in four center method, that is just to draw the isometric view of a circle. In offset method, it is used to draw the isometric view of a pyramid and cone. So pyramid and cone will have a single base. So the base will be drawn as per box method. Then the apex will be marked by offsetting the height from the center of the base. Right. So using that we will be drawing the isometric view. Right. So then you see, this is the isometric cube. It is shown in three phases. All the phases are inclined. You can see here. Right. It is the one. So this is the one, the box method. So if we, it's an octagonal prism shown here. The octagon, first of all, it is drawn. Then the box is enclosed with that octagon. Right. So enclosing that, I will be drawing a box. So that box, first of all, there is nothing but something like a square or rectangle. That I can draw it in any one of my iso plane. Right. So that iso plane, you see, the box is constructed, first of all, the box is constructed, so 1, 2, and along the two axes, 30, 30 degree axis, the two boxes, length is measured and it is transferred. The other corner, again, it is measured and transferred, okay, from the corners. Now, the points of the corresponding corners of the octagon, you can see it is measured and it is transferred to the corresponding locations. Right. So that is, once that is transferred on the box, whatever box, so then that corners will be joined together. So this is nothing but the isometric view of the octagon. So you can see there is going to be the isometric view of the octagon. Do we have any clarification in this? So far it is closed with a box. Okay, that box, first of all, it is drawn to using the iso axis. So on the box, the locations of the corners are measured and it is transferred. You will see that. Okay. But then the second method is the, suppose instead of octagon, if it is a circle, so I have to go for a
four-center
method. That four-center method, what is four-center method? Just you see here. First of all, the circle in an isometric view will look like this. The circle in isometric view will look like this. It won't be a circle. It will be something like an ellipse or in some other coordinate. How I have to draw it in an isometric view? What I will be doing? First of all, the circle will be enclosed with that box. Okay. The circle in the box will be a perfect square. So that square, I will be marking four centers of the four sides of the square. You can see here, it is going to be enclosed with that box. So I will be marking four centers of the four sides of the square. So there is 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I will be connecting these centers. You can see here, I will be connecting what it is doing. First of all, it is constructing the using the other two axes. So the previous one it used x and y axis. Here it is using what axis? X and z axis it is using. I am constructing a square, isometric view of the square. First of all, you can see it is constructing the isometric view of the square. So x and z axis, using that I am using square I have constructed. Then the four centers I have marked in that isometric square. Then see, it is connecting from one center to the opposite corner. So similarly, you can see the other center to an opposite corner. Opposite corner like this, it is connecting. Similarly, you can see the intersection, it is marked as E. Similarly, other two centers is connected to the opposite corner and the intersection is marked as F. Now, what I will be doing, just using this as center or B as center. See how it is drawn. Using B as center, B4 as radius. So I will be drawing an arc up to center 3. Right, there is one segment of the isometric view of the circle. Similarly, using D as center, D2 as radius, from 2 to 1, or D1 as radius from 1 to 2, I can draw another arc. So you can see here, D as center, D2, 1, 2, 2. Then the remaining segments, I have to connect it, so that is from 1 to 4 and 2 to 3. So which one I can use it for center? The intersection, what you have obtained from the four center, right, that is E and F. So using E as center, E1 as radius, I can continue this arc up to 4. So E as center, you can see here, using E as center, right, using E as center, E4 as radius, from 4 to 1. Similarly, F as center, F2, 3, 4. So this way I can finish my iso circle. Right. More clearly your problems you will see. If you have any clarification, you can ask it during from now. If you are solid, the pyramid, if it is given. So we have seen the third method, that is an offset method. So the pyramid will have a base and it will have a apex. Right. So base will be constructed as usual, something like a box method. You can see as usual the base is constructed in an iso plane using either x and y axis. You can see the hexagonal base, it is closed with the box. First of all, so the hexagonal base. goes to the box, then that hexagonal base is using 30-30 degree iso axis. It is drawn a horizontal line, then 30-30 degree iso x and y axis is used. The box is constructed first of all. So inside to that box, the hexagonal base is iso, view of the hexagonal base is constructed, right, drawn. So the hexagonal base is over. Once it is over, then the height, the axis height will be transferred from the center of the box what you have drawn. Center of the box. You see the axis height, it is offset head. So where you have the apex here in this iso plane, iso hexagon, it will be the center, that is the center of the rhombus, okay, that box what you have drawn. That is going to be your center. From there, I will be offsetting the height of the, because you see here, the height is transferred here, from here to that, the apex is small. So that is nothing but the offsetting. So offsetting the apex, then this offsetted one from the apex is connected to all the base corners. That is nothing but your isometric view of the solid. So the isometric planes is nothing but in your cube the faces, okay, what are the faces, the three faces what you have tilted and you are looking at while tilting my cube, that three faces of the cube is nothing but my three isoplanes of that isometric view, right, three isoplanes, that is nothing but x and y axis of the iso axis will, by enclosing that I will have an x, y isoplane, right. Similarly, by enclosing y and z axis of the iso axis, I will have an x, z isoplane. By enclosing x and z, y and z, I will have y, z isoplane, right. So, I will have three axes, right. By enclosing, suppose this is x, y, z. Enclosing x and z, I will have a axis plane. So this plane is my xy isoplane, right? So by enclosing x and z, so this line what I have drawn, how it is? It is parallel to z axis, and what I am going to draw, it is going to parallel to x axis. So by enclosing x and z, this plane is called xz isoplane. Right. Similarly, by parallel to y axis, when you draw a line like this, and parallel to z axis like this, by enclosing this x and z and y axis, this is yz isoplane. Right. So I have three isoplanes. So depending upon the orientation of the isometric view, what you are going to draw, so I have to use a plane, any one of these three planes. If I have a vertical component like this, so if you want to represent an isometric view vertically by resting the solid, the prism, vertically, so which plane I have to go for to draw the iso view of the base? Which plane I have to use it? So x, y. So that horizontal line will be drawing 30-30 degree using the box we will be constructing using x, z plane. So inside to that I will be drawing my iso view of the any hexagon polygon. Right. Then I will be correcting for z axis. Right. So suppose I have a solid, you want to draw an isometric view like this, which is lying on the ground. Okay, which plane I have to use it? I can use any two planes. So I can use YZ plane, I can draw my base here, you can go for height, length in the other axis. So YZ plane will be used for length, I will be using X axis. So either I can use XZ plane, for length I can use Y axis. So if a component is lying on the ground, upright. If the component is kept vertical, I have to use XY plane to draw the isometric view of the base. Then for the height, I will be using Z axis. Right, is it clear? So the three isometric planes you have, that you have to use it properly, using to represent a solid in a three-dimensional isometric view, either vertically or either it is lying down. Okay, correspondingly, you have to use the isometric planes. Right, take a problem. So draw the isometric view of a square prism, of a square prism of base side, square prism of base side.
What will be this?
D. Right. this here, this will be D. So how I can obtain my C? You can measure it, and using compass you can do it. What I have advised you, see here, what you can do it? Just you fix your drafter here, okay, to the x-axis, you move your drafter parallel to that. Okay, you fix your drafter to the x-axis, maybe move your drafter parallelly. Okay, so from there you can draw a parallel line. You can fix your drafter to y-axis, right? You can move your drafter to B. Okay, you can move your drafter to B, you can draw a parallel line. Right, where it intersects, that is going to be my C. Since it is a square, what is the location of A and C? It will be exactly vertical, it will be aligned with the other axis. If it is a rectangle, it will differ. Since it is a square, A and C will be exactly vertical with the aligned with the another axis. It won't have to be an offset. Right. Now once it is over, this is my base of the square. So how I can proceed for my height? Anybody? How I can proceed for my height? So once you have in isometric, you have to draw the base. After base, the height will be erected. Okay, it is projected along the another axis. Either downwards or upwards. Okay, normally you have the axis, z axis downward. So what I can do is, in an opposite direction, z axis I can erect it. Okay, you see here, the z axis is this. Vertically upwards. So along this, so from all the base corners of the prism, I have to erect the height. What is the height it is given? 60. Measure 60 mm from all the corners. So this is going to be my z-axis. Okay, upward. So from all the corners, I can erect. You have any clarification? It's a prism. So you have two bases. Suppose this is A, B, C. Another base we can rotate it as B, Q. Yes, right. The other base we can represent it as P, Q, R, straight. So from all the base corners, I am erecting the height for 60 mm along the z axis. Right. So along the z axis, so perpendicular to the reference plane what you have drawn. So from all the base corners is 60. So this is going to be my P. This is going to be my Q, R and S. Okay, connecting this. So it is a square prism. All its heights are square prism. So if you are drawing the two-dimensional view, you can dimension it here. You draw my, as I told, all your data should be dimensioned. Two-dimensional, if you have, you can show the dimensions here. Otherwise, you can show the dimension in a three-dimensional manner. You neatly you have to dimension it. Right. Here I can dimension it. Base. I'm going to have my two things, so I can dimension here. So this is 50. Height if I have, this is going to be. So you have any clarification? This is how we have to draw the isometric view. Okay, how to draw the base most of all using any isometric plane, then you have to use another axis for height or length. Right. So you continue this problem. So is it over? Finished. See here, definitely you have to use your drafter. Right. So you continue this problem. A square pyramid. Of base side of 30 mm, 30 mm of base side 30 mm and height or altitude height height 40 mm is kept centrally over the prism, is kept centrally over the prism, is kept centrally over the prism. Draw the isometric view of the combined solid. Draw the isometric view of the combined solid. Have any clarification, right? The problem is clear. The square pyramid, I am going to keep it over this, and I have to draw the isometric view for this. Square pyramid, if I keep it over this, so that is, it is kept centrally. This is the top view of the prism. This is the top view of the square prism. If I draw the top view of the pyramid, which is having, in, which is kept centrally in this, how it would be? It is 30 mm. Base side is 30 mm. So 30 mm in the sense, 30 mm, so this is going to be my center, okay, 30 mm square from me is the top view of the combined solid, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is apex 4, right, so it is here, so this is the top view of the combined solid, so I have a square pyramid also on the top, this is the top view of the combined solid. So this dimension, what is that? 30. That is 30. Okay. Side of the square pyramid is 30. Now how I can construct this over this in isometric, very good. What I can do it? So I have to look for this one. If I able to get this one from this box in the top, okay, this is my top face. If we are able to get the top, 1, so 1 is from P, how I can arrive at the corner 1 of the square pyramid, square base, so it is how much distance from this corner, so what is these distances, from this corner, how I can arrive at the corner 1, what is this distance going to be? 10. So overall 15, this is 30, this is going to be 10. What will be this? Again 10. Right. So what I can do it from P, I can mark corner 1 of the square from it. So from P, I can draw 10 mm. I can mark 10 mm here. Similarly from here, I can mark 10 mm here. Right. Right, so I am marking 10 mm from this. So now I am considering this PQRS as a base axis, x axis as PQ and y axis as PS. So from that I am going to mark one corner 1 of the square from me. So from B, I am marking along x axis 10 mm, along y axis 10 mm. Then using your drafter by drawing parallel lines from PQ and PS. There is a corner of time. So what is that? What is that? That is 1. So from there, now I can draw the square of 30 mm. Similar to this. So parallel to x axis, I can draw 30 mm. Parallel to y axis, I can draw 30 mm. I can close a square base. Do you have any clarification? Right. From 1. So arriving 1 is the thing. So once you have arrived 1, parallel to x-axis, I can draw a line to 30 mm. I can draw a line to 30 mm. So parallel to y-axis, I can draw a line to 30 mm. Right. So it will give me 2 and 4. Right. So then, using the same drafter, parallel to y-axis, I can move it here. I can draw from 2, I can draw. Similarly, using drafter, parallel to x axis, I can move it here, I can finish off the base square. So this is the base of the square pyramid I have drawn. Right. So this is the base of the square pyramid I have drawn. So then, how I can finish the square pyramid? Pyramid is drawn using offset procedure. So the height is used from the center of the base, right? The height is used offsetted from the center of the base. So the square pyramid is construction. So the center, first of all, I have to mark it. Center of the square, I have to mark it. From here, from the center of the base of the pyramid, I have to measure the height of the pyramid. What is the height of the pyramid?
40.
40. From here, along which axis? Along Z axis. Along Z axis, 40 mm I have to measure. So 25 to 15. So that is going to be my apex. This is 1, 2, 3 apex O. So this apex O, it is offsetted. Right. Now, how I can finish it? The pyramid. So the apex I can join to all the base corners of the pyramid. So the apex. Now this is the pyramid. I can show it like this. Now, the visible edges alone will be showing in your isometric view in a dark manner using your H pencil. Okay. Darkly can show the visible edges. So what are all the visible edges here? So apart in this base, first of all in the prism base, the visible edge is this. Can you see? Similarly the visible edge is AB. Can you see BC or DC? It is hidden in an isometric view. It is hidden. You need not show it in dotted line. So the visible edges alone you can dot and I can see A and B. So I can connect this vertical edge AB. Similarly I can see D and S, that vertical edge D and S is connected. Similarly B and Q. So in this top base, which one I can see? PQ I can see. PS I can see. Then Q to up to this, S to up to this. Okay, the remaining whatever going inside it is not visible. So before that we will finish off the pyramid. Darkening the pyramid. This base of the pyramid is visible. This base side of the pyramid is visible. This side is not visible. Sorry. This base side is not visible. Right. So this slant edge is visible. So the slant edge mode to 1 is visible. Slant edge mode to 2 is visible. Right. The inner side edges are not visible. So it will be in light 1. So this prism's top face up to this is visible. Finally, you have to darken the visible edges like this. Okay, so this is going to be an isometric view. Whatever dimensions you are not able to show it in this two-dimensional view, you have to try to show it in your isometric view. See here, this height is not able to show it. I will go for showing that in isometric view. This is the height. Right, this is a square prism and a square pyramid. Okay, together I have drawn. So if I have a pentagonal prism or hexagonal, what I have to do? Pentagon I have to draw it. First of all, I have to enclose it with a box. That box you have to construct it. Inside that box, you have to draw the hexagon. And you can go for drawing the isometric view of the hexagon. See that a cone of base diameter. Centrally over here. square slab. Square slab. Square slab. Slab is a square prism. Okay, thin square prism. A square slab of size. Of size. By 20 mm. Square slab of size 60 by 20 mm. 60 by 20 mm in the sense 60 mm is nothing by 20 square side. Side length 20 mm is the thickness of that slab. Right. That is height of the slab. So centrally over a square slab of size 60 by 20 mm. Right. To so draw the isometric view, of these combined solids, draw the isometric view of these combined solids. So for this, you need not draw the two-dimensional view. Okay, if you want, you can draw it to show the dimension, because the slab is a square. So square size, you know, if it is not square, you can draw it. If hexagon pentagon, you can draw it. The slab is square, you need not draw it. Similarly, the cone, this base is nothing but a circle. The circle, if I close it with a box, that will be a square again. The circle, if I close it with a box, that will be again a square. So even though if you want to draw it, a square slab, like this, square slab. Okay, on this centrally over this I have a cone. Okay, this is the top view of the combined solid. Slab is a square. Then I have a cone. Okay, this is the top view of the combined solid. So the front view would be, you see the front view. So this is the slab. First of all, using these two isometric axes, I can draw the base of the square slab. Okay, base of the square slab is square. So I am keeping A here. So what is this length? A to B. A to B is 60. It's a square. 60. See, it is a square. It is 60. So A to B is going to be 60. So you measure 60 in your compass. Measure from A to along X axis. See, this is along one axis. Measure 60. Measure 60 and mark B. Okay, this is going to be my B. Right. Similarly, this way. A to D. What is the distance? It is again 60. So along this axis, I can measure 60. You can measure 60. I can mark. What is this rotation? D. Right. So I have A, B, D. So how I can arrive at C? So all your lines, you have to draw it. Mostly you will be drawing parallel to your reference line. So you fix your graphical scale to this axis. Parallel to your axis. Isometric axis. So move your, fix your graphical to this axis. What I can do it? Once I have fixed, wherever I move, I can get the parallel line to this axis. So I can move my graphical to this location. Parallel to that, I can draw an. Now this line is parallel to AB. So how I can arrive at C? A now B, B, C, huh? Parallel to my axis. Another isometric axis. I can fix my graphical to this. Fix it. Once it is fixed, and then you move it to this location B. So wherever it meets, that intersection is my location of C. Right. See. So I have drawn the base. Now this A and C has to be on the same line. Why? It is a square. If the base is not a square, this A and C won't match on the other axis, vertical axis. Okay. Since it is a square, exactly A and C will be on the same vertical line and on another axis. So now this is what you have drawn. It is my base. Once this base is over, what I can do it? I have to go for my height of this slab. What is this height of the slab? 20 mm. So base is over. From all my corners, I can rise the height of the base to 20 mm. That is on another axis of isometric side. So another axis, I have used X and Y axis to draw the base. So another axis I have, that is Z axis, isometric Z axis. That is perpendicular. Vertically upward, so vertical axis like this, that is another axis. Along this, on all the corners, base corners, I can measure 20. I can draw another base, okay, to show the isometric view of this slab. So here from here, so you fix your graphical to the horizontal line, the another scale will be perpendicular, right? So using that, you erect the heights from this slab. Diameter of the circle is 40. Right. it should be 10 mm, 10 mm, because this is 40, the overall this thing is 60. So this will be 10, this will be 10. So this is my 10 mm, so this is again my 10 mm. So what it's doing to arrive at this one from here, P. What I can do it? So from here, PQ, right, parallel to that, fixable bracket, parallel to that. Otherwise, what I can do it? From this corner P, along this axis, X axis, PQ, I can measure, I can mark 10 mm. I can mark 10 mm. I can mark 10 mm. Similarly, along PS, that is Y axis, I can mark 10 mm. Right. So from these location, what I can do is to draw this square, construction square. So parallel to this PS, I can move my drafter. So fix your drafter to this axis, move your drafter then you draw a parallel line. Right. Similarly, you fix your drafter to X axis, that is PQ, then move your drafter to this location. Parallel to that, I will get a meeting location. That location is what? My corner one of the square enclosed for the circle. Right, so this is my one. Now, can you construct a square here? Can you construct the square 1, 2, 3, 4? Right, enclosing the circle. So what is this length? It is 40. Right, from 1, parallel to x-axis, parallel to x-axis, I can draw a horizontal, that is a parallel line. So along that I can measure 40 mm. 40 mm, I can mark a corner, that is going to be my, what is that, 2. Right, so parallel to y-axis, along this, so I can measure 40 mm from 1. I can mark, what is that, 4. Right. So then I can enter 3, similar to the previous one, right? So I can draw parallel to x, y axis and x axis from here. This is my 3. Before constructing the isometric view of this circle, I have drawn the construction of a square box enclosing the circle. Right. So that I have drawn it. That I have drawn it. Right. Now inside to that, I have to show the isometric view of the circle. Right. How to draw the isometric view of circle? What is the method you have to use? Last part we have to say. Four center method, right? Four center method you have used. Listen, all of you. Once you have drawn the circle, you have to go for four center method to draw the isometric view of a circle. So you have a square box, right? To mark the four centers of this, four sides of the square. So what is the center of 1 and 2? It is 20 mm. You mark the center. So what is 1 and 4? You mark the center. Here. Here we mark center. So these are all my four centers. I have marked. Listen carefully. Listen all of you. So I have. In an envelope, this is a square enclosing the circle. Listen all of you. Listen. This is a square enclosing the four circle. So I am marking four centers. Four sides center. Listen. Then, so this center. Say, suppose this is the center, say 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So this fourth center, listen, I am running, joining with a 2x line to the opposite corner. Similarly, this third center to this opposite corner, right? Like this, that will be an intersection location. So you mark it in some other notation. One, you can mark it, otherwise you can leave it, right? Notate it. Then similarly, the center of 1, I can connect, join it to the opposite corner. Here 2, similarly, I can join it to the opposite corner. Right. There, I will have another intersection. intersection location, okay? If you want to rotate it, you can rotate it. Now, I have to draw an iso circle here. So what I can do is that using this corner, using this corner, right? Then using this as center, in your compass, you have to draw in compass only, okay? Using this as center, then 3 as radius. So say this is as center, 3 as radius, up to this as radius. I can draw an arc. I can draw an arc up to 2. Conveniently in my compass. Conveniently in my compass. Is it clear? Similarly, what I can do is, one segment I have got. Similarly, this as center, I can close it. This portion again. This as center, this corner as center, this as much as radius, I can draw another arc to this. Right. Once it is over, so this segment of circle I have to close it, this segment of circle I have to close it. Which one I can use it as center? Right. Intersection E. Intersection E, I can use it as center. E4 as radius. Because this is a circular arc, I have to continue this. Right, I have to continue this to finish. So E as center, E4 as radius, I can close, draw an arc. Right, draw an arc. Close an arc like this. Then similarly, F as center, F as center, F2 as radius, I can continue this arc, close, I can close this arc. Like this, okay. This is the one, your iso circle. So this iso circle, to draw this iso circle, the circle you have to close it with a box. That box, first of all, you have to construct it. Inside to that box, you have to draw the iso circle using four centers. Mark four centers of the four sides of the square. Join that centers with the opposite corner, diagonally opposite corners, right? So that will be two intersections you will have time. So using one as center, this corner as center, you can draw a segment of arc. This as center, same way you can draw another one. So then the intersection what you have obtained. So that as center, so E4 as radius, you can continue this arc. Okay, another segment. Similarly, F as center, F2 as radius, I can remaining segment, I can finish it off. So this is how you have to construct your iso circle. Right. So similarly, I have a square here of 40 sides. So you mark 4 centers. Using 4 center method, you finish the iso circle. Listen. Listen all of you. Tell me, Kavani. So once the iso circle of the cone base is drawn over the slab, listen. You mark the center of this circle, of center of the square box, what you have drawn for the circle. So that center I can mark it, right? So that center I can mark it. So from that, for pyramids or cones, I have to go for an offset method. So which one I am going to offset? The apex I am going to offset. So exactly from this location, what is the height of the apex from its base? What is the height? It is 15. So from this central location of the square box, right? You measure 50 mm. Along Z axis, you measure 50 mm. So from here, 50 mm, measure. So that is going to be my apex. Is it clear? From this location, center of the box, you measure 50 mm to mark the apex. That is nothing but I am offsetting from the base, the apex. So that is offset method. So once I have shown the apex, how I can finish the cone? You join this apex with a line tangent to the iso circle. Exactly tangent to the iso circle. So wherever it tangent, it touches, there join it. So this is going to be my cone. Right. Now, you have to show the visible edges alone in isometric view. You need not show the hidden details in dotted line. Only the visible lines, both the combined solid, you show it in a dark pencil, that is HBR, H pencil. So this is the visible line at our base. So this is going to be my visible line.
Thank you.
plane. Frustum of a square pyramid. Bottom base is 60 mm. Top base is 40 mm. Right. Then height is 40. Over that I have a sphere of diameter 30 mm. You are asked to draw the isometric view of the combined solids. Right. So what you can do is, you see here this frustum of a square pyramid. It's similar to the previous problem. What I can do is, I can draw a bottom square for 60 in isometric view. Then same thing I can project it to height. I can extend it to 40. So on the top square, I can go for an inner square of 40. So I can draw a bottom square of 60. I can rise it for 40 mm height. And on the top square, so inside to that I can draw a 40 mm square similar to the previous problem. So with that, I can finish off my frustum of a square pyramid. Over that, I have to draw a circle of, to show the sphere. Make it fast. First of all, you draw the isometric view of a frustum in 2H pencil. Don't darken it. Make it fast. Frustum of a square pyramid. Right. But the where the center of the sphere, you have to mark, that is essential. You see here, from here, as an isometric view, listen out of it. As an isometric view from the center of the top base of the frustum, if I measure the radius of the sphere, what is the radius of the sphere? 15. Right. So from here, 15 if I measure it. Here 15 if I measure it. And if I mark the center of the sphere, right. So using this as center, if I draw a circle, where it will end, it will be exactly, it will be going to the center here, center of the top face. But in an isometric view, it won't look like that. How it will be, the sphere, how it will be, the sphere's tangent will be, it will be little bit downwards to the, below the center of the top face. Right, top base. So what you have to use it to mark the center, to mark the center of the sphere from center of the top base, top square. So you have to use the, you should not use the true length, 15 mm. What you have to use it? You have to use the isometric scale. So what is the isometric scale for 15 mm? Isometric length for 15 mm. For 10 mm, the isometric length will be 8.2. For 1 mm it will be, isometric length is 0.82. For 10 mm it will be 8.2. For 15 mm, 12.3. For 15 mm, approximately it will be 12.3. So you have to measure for 15 mm, the isometric length will be 12.3 approximately, right? So you measure 12.3 in your compass from this center of the top base, measure 12.3 instead of measuring 15 mm, the actual true radius of the sphere. You use isometric scale, that is 12.3 from here. This is my center of the sphere. This distance, it is not 15, it is 12.3. 12.3 isometric radius. Isometric radius of sphere. Right. So the radius is 15. The isometric radius will be 12.3. So from this center, I have to mark the center of the sphere. So from that, what length I have to use for to draw this circle as radius in your compass? I'm going to draw a circle from this center, sphere center. So what should be the radius? I have to go for the true length. What is the radius? 15. So you measure 15 mm in your compass. That is the true radius of the sphere. So using this as center, draw a 15 mm radius circle. Definitely that circle will be going below the center of the top. Now Which is going to be the lowermost cutting point Cutting point 1 is the lowermost cutting point, that is in which side it is going to come in your box. So either M is on the M side of M or on the side of NO. The lowermost cutting point is on the side of M P. Right. The lower, isn't it of you? This is an important one. So you have to look at the corner. Okay. Which is on the side of the lower cutting point. Okay, suppose my cutting point 1 is lower cutting point. So on that side, whatever corner I have, that is M of my box. Okay, so the lowermost cutting point corresponding to that, I have a corner M in my box, enclosing box. That M you have to mark in your isometric view. The corner present. That M you have to mark it here. So this is my M. I'm going to keep my box M here in this corner, wherever the X and Y axis intersects. Right. With the reference line. Right, horizontal line. Is it clear? You should not keep N. If you keep N, what will happen? The section surface in your isometric view you are not able to show in your drawing. The section surface will be behind your drawing, right? Is it clear? So if you are carefully showing the corner M in this one in your isometric view, then only you can show the sectioned surface clearly in your isometric view. Right? Wrongly, if you are keeping N here, your section surface will go behind in your isometric view. Is it clear? That's why I am telling. So keep your corner, whichever to wherever you have the lowermost cutting point. Suppose I have a cutting plane, I have represented like this. Okay, instead of like this, listen, I have represented the cutting plane like this. So which side I will have a lower cutting point? N. Right. N side, N corner will be my lower cutting point. Okay, this side. So I have to keep N here. So depends upon your lowermost cutting point. The corresponding corner you have to keep it here in your isometric view. It is because to show the cut surface clearly in your isometric view. Right. So now I have M. You measure M to N distance. It is not a square. Definitely, if you are enclosing a hexagon or pentagon, it won't be a square. Right. If you are enclosing a circle, it will be a square. But if you are enclosing a hexagon or pentagon, regular hexagon or pentagon, it won't be a square. Why am I telling? So M to N distance you measure, what it would be? 50, 60, 50. That's the diameter, right? 50. So this 50 I can measure it along this x axis. So this is my N. Right. What is this distance? M to P. What is the distance we are getting? 40. Right. That distance
you have to keep it here.
How much we are getting?
43.
43.
45.
Right. So this is going to be my P. Clear. Now, by joining P and C, if it is a perfect square, the M and O will be on a vertical axis, Z axis, right? If it is a square. If it is not square, it will be definitely deviated. Right. Now, inside to this box, is it clear? First of all, you have to measure the box and you have to construct the isometric view of that box. Now inside that box you try to show the hexagon, right? Try to show the hexagon clearly. Now along MN, I have B and C, right? Isn't it obvious? Along MN I have B and C. From M to B distance you measure it. The same distance you will have here from P to F. O to E, okay, everything is symmetric, right? So from M to P distance you measure it, that distance in your compass, from M to P you cut it, similarly the same distance that you have here, 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 right? So I will have my four corners marked on the isometric view. That is my B, this is B. C. D. Yeah. Right. So what about A and D? It is exactly middle on side MP, right? Similarly, NO. So exactly middle. So this is my A. So by with two edge pencil, by joining this corner in your isometric view, I can show the isometric hexagonal plane alone. Right. Now I can construct, suppose I project this to the height, what I will get? I will get a hexagonal prism. Right. For the same height 60, from all the base corners, if I erect it, okay, I will have a hexagonal prism. Closing that, I will have a hexagonal prism. So what we want, a slant surface, cut surface, right? So from all your base corners, right, you draw vertical lines, that is along Z axis, you draw vertical lines. So from all these vertical edges, if I measure the same 60 mm and closing the top base, what I will have? I will have a hexagonal prism, right? So I don't want the isometric to have a hexagonal prism, the truncated prism I want, right? So how I, what height I have to measure it? What height I have to measure it from each corner, isn't it? From corner A, corner A, what is the height I have to measure to mark? Cutting point 1. So you measure this distance. Measure this distance from the front view. Okay, that's why we need the front view here. Okay. Orthographic view, right? So here from A to 1 distance, cutting point 1 distance you measure in your compass, you transfer from A to 1 vertical line. So what is that cutting point? That is my cutting point 1. Right, from A to 1. Then cutting point 2 and 6 will have the same distance. You measure it in your compass. Right. Then cutting point 2 is on HB. Cutting point 6 is on F. So the same distance you measure it and take it from B, you mark it from C, from F, you mark it from F. Right. So this is my, similarly, cutting point 5, 3 and 5, the distance you measure it from C to, on vertical edge C, I will have cutting point 3, on vertical edge E, I will have cutting point 5, so vertical edge C, I will have cutting point, what is that, 3. Vertical edge E, I will have cutting point 5, right? Then you measure, listen, this cutting point 4 distance on from D I have to measure. In your isometric view, D corner I have here, D corner I have here, from here I have to measure it. I have to mark the cutting point is 4. Cutting D is this. Is it clear? So in your isometric base of your hexagon from the corner location, measure the cutting point heights in your front view and transfer that on the corresponding vertical edges in your isometric view, right? So once you have marked all the cutting points, the cutting points connect, join it with a straight line. That is going to be a slant surface. You see here, the cutting points 1 and 2. 1. Right. Once this is over. Right. This is the cut surface I have shown. Now, the retained bottom portion of the vertical edges and the base edges I have to dominate. going to be your final retained prism. Isometric, we have the final retained prism, right? Have any clarification in this? Right, do it. Take the next problem, a cylinder. It is cut by a plane about 45 degree incline to HP, 45 degree incline to HP. And meeting the axis 10 mm from the top face, meeting the axis 10 mm from top base. Draw the isometric view of the retained bottom portion of the cylinder. Draw the isometric view of the retained bottom portion of the cylinder. Quickly draw the cylinder and represent the cutting point. Okay. Draw the retained portion, then we will proceed for the isometric view. So as for cylinder, isometric view, the circle, I have to close it with a box. That box should be a square. So square prism, first of all you construct, inside you put two circles, bottom base, bottom square, you draw a circle in 4 center method, top square you draw a circle in 4 center method, right. So here, listen, as for isometric view for cylinder, I advise you, you divide it into 8 equal divisions, right, not 12 equal divisions, 8 equal divisions, each division will be 45 degree, right. Divide the circle into 8 equal divisions. It will be easier for you. Read fast. As per the given orientation and representation of the cutting plane is done. And you do a two-dimensional view, okay, front and top view. So the retained portion of the cylinder is this. Only the HDM generator should be darkened. And the cutting plane is 45 degree inclined and it meeting the axis at 10 mm from the top base. Right. So the cutting point. You can see, look at the cutting points from the bottom. So it cuts the extreme generator, then another generator, C, then it cuts the base. So in base, I will have two cutting points. Okay, if a cutting plane cuts the base, I will have two cutting points. That is 4 and 5 on the top base, then come back on the along the cutting plane, searching for the hidden generator point, cutting point 6 and 7. Right, totally I have 7 cutting points, including two base cutting points, top base cutting. See here, the cylinder, okay, if I enclose it with a box, the whole cylinder, if I enclose it with a box, it will be a square prism of base side, square base side equal to the diameter of the circle cylinder and the height of the prism will be 60, right? So what if I have done, you see here, the circle So, first of all, I am going to construct the isometric view of a square prism. So, you see here, the square prism is constructed as usual, right, for the height 60 mm and the side 50 mm. See here, inside to the square prism, okay, I have to show my cylinder. So, the cylinder will have two circular bases, okay, the circular isometric view of two circles, first of all, I have to draw it on the base of the square prism. You know four center method how to draw the isometric view of a circle. So using four center method in one base you construct an isocircle. Similar on the another base you construct another isocircle. Then neatly you mark the generator, cutting generator points on the two bases and try to show the generators in your isometric view with two edge pencil. Okay, make it fast. Thank you. generator point. So if you have divided this into 12 divisions, finding out your generator location will be difficult. That's why I told you divide this in 8 divisions as far as isometric view concerned. Right. So otherwise finding out the locations of the generator base point will be difficult. So you divide it into 8 divisions, easily I can mark the generator location, easily I can show my generator. Once this is over, this is a cylinder, right? We want a retained cut cylinder, truncated cylinder. You see here, similar to the previous problem, you measure the cutting point distance in your front view from the reference line. You see here, cutting point 1 is on generator A. You measure this distance from A, you mark it. You measure this distance from A, you mark it. So that is my cutting point. Then, so these are all my generator cutting points. Listen. Coming to this 4 and 5 base cutting point, top base cutting point, how I have to mark it? This cutting, listen all of you, this 4 and 5 cutting point, back falls on the top isocircle. Right, 4 and 5 cutting point, it falls on the top isocircle, that is on this circle. On this circular curve, I have to mark my cutting point 4 and 5, is it clear? So that 4 and 5, how I can mark it? this distance, either I have to project that to the box, what I have drawn. So if I project this to the box, so wherever it intersects the box, right? So where I have the cutting point actually 4 and 5, 4 is here, 5 is on the circle, here, right? So I have to mark this location from N to this location on the box. I have to mark first of all N to this location. So nothing but this distance, right? This distance from N I have to mark it. So the same distance N I have here, right? So it is on the top base, not on the bottom base. This is N, this is O, this is M actually, this is P, right? So this distance I have to measure it and I have to transfer from N. This is the location I am interested. Now from this location, what I have to do? I have to draw a line, straight line, parallel to which axis? Y axis. Parallel to NO line. Parallel to NO line, that is nothing but Y axis. Right. Parallel to that, from this location, I have to draw a line. Like this. Now, which is going to be my cutting point 4 and 5? This is going to be my cutting point 4 and 5. Wherever this line intersects the isocircle, so the cutting point is going to be on this circle, okay? So wherever it intersects the isocircle, so that location is my cutting point 4, right? Wherever this line intersects the isocircle here, that location is my cutting point 5. Is it clear? Is it clear? So just measure this distance. So from N, that distance you measure it in your box, that is on the top box from N. Then you draw a line from that location parallel to this NO, that is Y axis. So that parallel line will intersect the isocircle at some location. That is going to be my cutting point 4 and 5. Now in a sequence, so you see here, once the cutting plane touches the cylinder, I will get an edge here on the top base. Right. Then a cut surface will come. I have to connect these cutting points with a smooth curve. Right. Since it is a cylinder with a smooth curve, I have to connect it. To try to get a smooth curve first of all, then you got the name. Then you got the name. Once you have got this, then you got the name. The retained portion, the visible edges alone you got the name. That is going to be your final isometric. You will see here.
With the base edge
parallel to VP. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to VP, comma 30 degree inclined to HP, 360, 30 degree inclined to HP, and bisecting the axis, and bisecting the axis. Draw the isometric view of the retained pyramid. Draw the isometric view of the retained pyramid. Quickly draw the projection of the pyramid. Represent the cutting plane, cutting point, and draw the isometric view of the base alone. Make it fast. So it almost cuts all the slant edges, so you have 5 cutting points. To show the isometric view of the retained pyramid, a truncated pyramid, I need a sectional top view. I need a cross section in profile, okay. Then only I can proceed for my isometric view. So that I have projected all my cutting points to my top view, I have got the profile of the cross section, that is apparent section I have got in my top view, right? So by projecting the 5 cutting points, right? Then the base pentagon I have enclosed with a box MNOP, right? That box won't be a square. MN will be more, MP will be less, little bit less. So why? So suppose I draw an isometric view of the box MNOP, it will be like this. The M, if I draw a vertical line, it won't coincide with O. If it is a square, it will coincide. So since it is not a square, as for hexagon and pentagon, the enclosing box won't be a square. So once I have drawn the isometric view of a box M and OP, inside to that box, I can mark the appropriate location of the pentagonal corner. You see, corner B is on MN. So before that, you have to mark the corner in your isometric view carefully. So which corner I have to keep, as usual from previous, like previous problem, wherever the corner I have the lowermost cutting point. So either M or N. If N I have a cutting point which is at a higher location, at M I have a cutting point A1, that is the lowermost cutting point from the reference line. So I have to mark M of my box on the reference line, right? So I have to mark M, then to close the box, draw the isometric view of the box, then inside to that box, carefully mark the pentagonal corners, measuring the appropriate location in the top view, right? So this M to B, it is exactly middle, I can mark it. So similarly, M to A, the same distance will be M to C. So M to A distance, you can measure it in your compass, M to A, M to C, right? So similarly, P to E distance, the same distance will be O to D. So this distance, I can measure it in my compass, P to E, I have transferred here, right? So conveniently, I have marked my base point. So by joining that with a straight line, it is nothing but the isometric view of a pentagon alone. Now, construct the isometric view of the truncated pyramid. So I have apparent section here. Look at carefully, I have an apparent section, cutting points, it holds 5 cutting points. What I am going to do, I have to draw this apparent section in this isometric plane, box. How I can draw it? Anybody? The same thing, I have to draw it here as an isometric apparent section, right? How I can draw it? So what you can do is, listen, the one, so all these cutting points, you horizontally you project it to along MP line, okay, MP straight line. See here, cutting point 1 I am projecting like this, cutting point 2 I am projecting drawing a horizontal line. So this is the location 1, this is 2, similarly 3, right, similarly 4, 5, right. So these are all the locations 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this way I have projected all my cutting points horizontally to the line along MB. Now these locations I can carefully measure it and I can transfer it along MB line in my isometric view. So, carefully I have transferred these extended location along MP. I have marked these 5 locations here. Then what I have to do to get these cutting point located in my isometric view? I have to draw a horizontal line. I have to draw a horizontal line from 2, this location. If I draw a horizontal line parallel to MN, that is x-axis, so from 2 I can measure this 2 distance, that I can transfer it there. Right. So what I am going to do, from 2 parallel to x-axis, that is MN side, I am drawing a parallel line. Similarly, 3 I can draw a parallel line. 1, 4, 5. Now along these lines I can transfer, measure the cutting point location, exact locations, exact location, and I can transfer these locations. Then I can draw the apparent section.
So here this distance is 30. From here to here.
That is going to be my cutting point location 2. Then this 1
That is my cutting point 4.
0.5 vertical height. Cutting 0.5. So this way I have to transfer all my cutting points. Now I have to connect the cutting point, 5 cutting points with a straight line. That is, that will give me the cut surface. See, cutting points, say, these cutting points I am marking here. Right. So these cutting points, if I join it with a straight line, now to finish the truncated pyramid, what I have to do? So these cutting points, cut surface location, I have to join it with a slant edge to the corresponding base edge, base corner. So 8 to 1, if I join it, that is my slant edge. So B to 2 is my other slant edge. Then C to 3 is my other slant edge. Then 4 to D, it is hidden. Then 5 to E. Right. Then the base edges I can join it. So the base edge, what is the visible base edge? This. This. Right. So this is going to be my retail truncated pyramid. Is it clear? The cutting point transferring is a little bit confusing. Actually, you have to draw the sectional top view. So apparent section you have to get. The apparent section location, actually you have to transfer it to your box. Right. By projecting that to one side, so that side location you have to mark it. Then you draw a horizontal line parallel to the x-axis, that is MN side. Then similar to that, from this location you mark the appropriate location of the apparent section on the inside the box. Once you have got that 5 location, from that you have to draw vertical lines, that is height along z axis. So from that location you have to mark the height of each cutting point from the reference line. That I can mark it. Right. So by connecting that cutting point will give me the iso slant surface. Right, cut surface. Then that cut surface point we join to the corresponding base corners. So I have 5 base corners, corresponding base corners I have to join it. Then the retained edges alone you have to darken it. Is it clear? Which is in the shape of a square, frustum of a square pyramid. Right. So frustum of a square, that's been how it will be. It will be like this. Suppose it is a square pyramid, it will be like this. Right. So bottom I will have a square, top I will have a square. How I can draw this? Isometric view of this. It's nothing but a frustum. The other way frustum you have drawn in your first two problems. Okay, three problems, right? A square I can draw it, a square prism I can construct it, inside I can construct another square. By joining that I will have a frustum. Here what you have to do, the bottom square. So inside to that I have to draw a small square. So the top square will be remain same. Right. The top square will remain same. Like this. Is it clear? It will be like this. Right. The first two problems we have drawn, the square prism. Square prism, the first box, the bottommost square, inside to that I have to draw a small square. Then you have to proceed for the, so already you will have another base. By connecting that I will have a dustbin like this. Is it clear? Similar to the first two problems. So suppose I have a dustbin of pentagonal, a shape of a pentagonal, prism of a pentagonal pyramid. What do you have to do? You'll have two pentagons. So bottom one will be a small pentagon, top one will be a bigger pentagon. So bigger pentagon, for a bigger pentagon box, you have to construct a prism. right? So the bottom box, inside to that I have a smaller print again, right? For that you have to close it with a box, that you have to construct it. Then on the top one you will have a bigger print again, right? The same way you have to do it. Have any clarification in that? Have any clarification? Right. Suppose you take a problem. Yeah. Draw the isometric view of a frustum of pentagonal pyramid. Draw the isometric view of frustum of a pentagonal pyramid of bottom base side 40 mm and top base side. Draw the isometric view of a frustum of a pentagonal pyramid of bottom base side 40 mm, top base side 20 mm and height 50 mm. And height 50 mm. Right. So you see, I will have, so bottom base side is 40. So I can draw a pentagon. Bottom base side is a bigger base, top base is a smaller base, height is 50. So this is going to be my front view of the frustum. Right. Front view of the frustum. Now I can draw the isometric view of this. I can close the bigger pentagon with a box. So if I close this with a box, say 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have to construct a prism for 1, 2, 3, 4 rectangle, right, of height what? 50 mm. Right. I can construct a prism, isometric view of a prism. So inside to the prism, prism's bottom base I can construct a bigger pentagon. Top base I can construct a smaller pentagon by closing that smaller pentagon also with a box. Right. On the top base, I have to construct another box to this nature, okay, to this size. So exactly that location. So inside to that box, I can construct this smaller pentagon. By connecting these two pentagons, I will have a frustum of a pentagonal pyramid. Right. That is going to be the isometric. Right. With this, we will close the isometric projection.